Well, gentlemen of the press, as we recall, a few days back, we did bring the attention of Mr. President to allegations running in the nation about the purchase of Etisalat and Keystone Bank by members or associates of the first family. Today, and if you recall, we did say Mr. President to respond in person because it touches on his best selling point of his, which is the assumed integrity. To this point, it is only the media aides of Mr. President and the Harleys that are howling in the media. We are here to hear Mr. President on this issue. I welcome you to the first press conference of the People's Democratic Party Presidential Campaign Organization. And in bringing you out today, we have brought you out to raise issues concerning fresh plot by the Buhari presidency and the All Progressives Congress to compromise INEC to rig the 2019 election, as well as other sundry issues that have been discussed in private and public areas of our nation. The People's Democratic Party Presidential Campaign Organization calls for an urgent investigation into the alleged link between the reportedly diverted military funds and the 1.032 trillion naira said to have been used by President Muhammadu Buhari's family members for corrupt acquisition in a Etisalat now known as Nine Mobile and Keystone Bank. The PPCO calls for an independent and system-wide investigation by the Interpol, the Directorate of State Services, as well as the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC, on the alleged links between the two funds. This concerted investigation has become imperative following President Buhari's failure to directly speak out on the allegations against his family members, as well as his refusal to explain how they came about the sum of 1.032 trillion for the alleged acquisition. We make this demand in view of public insinuations that the money may have been sourced from funds meant for the purchase of weapons for our soldiers. More so, the Buhari presidency has blatantly refused to respond to allegations that military fund is being used to finance President Buhari's re-election campaign, which had manifested in the use of military fund to make mementos by the Minister of Defense for the campaign of President Muhammadu Buhari. The PPCO is deeply worried by the disturbing video of our gallant soldiers languishing and being killed by insurgents due to neglect and failure of the Buhari administration to adequately equip them in the front. Our presidential campaign organization is also unhappy by similar videos showing our soldiers protesting and threatening to retreat from the front while grumbling against their neglect by the Buhari administration. This should never be the way to go for our nation. Our soldiers are recognized, brave soldiers, and they have continued to show the highest form of professionalism and unmatched patriotism in risking and laying down their lives in defense of our fatherland. Therefore, any action that is capable of reducing their morale in their front must never be allowed. The PPCO invites Nigerians to continue to be at alert and give all support to our fighting troops, as the fight against terrorism in our land must continue to be a collective effort. We therefore insist on an inquest and urge Nigerians to give their support in the regard of finding out how much of the fund meant to purchase weapons for our soldiers have been diverted into buying Etisalat, now known as Nine Mobile, and Keystone Bank. On another note, the attention of our presidential campaign organization has been drawn to a vicious attempt by the All Progressives Congress to use diversionary tactics to dismiss allegations of corruption hanging directly on President Muhammadu Buhari. The APC is attempting to dismiss revelation that family members of President Buhari were involved in acquiring substantial shares in both the Etisalat, now known as Nine Mobile, and the Keystone Bank, and this is worth over a trillion naira. We want Nigerians to note that the PDP had already challenged President Buhari to personally speak out on these allegations. We note that President Buhari had the occasion of the launch of his campaign in Akwa Ibom last week, and his New Year address message to Nigerians to deny these grave allegations, but he decided to shy away from it. The PPCO unequivocally stands by its actions that President Muhammadu Buhari has soiled his hands on corruption and enrichments and has resorted to sending his aides to put up frivolous defenses. We were very clear and unambiguous when we did say that Mr. President should respond to our candidate. We said he should do so in person. We never said his aides should take up the responsibility. There are aides who are talking to Nigerians and they have no direct access to the principal. We hereby insist that Mr. President should rise in defense of his best-selling point, assumed integrity, by personally responding to the Etisalat and Keystone Bank scandal. The PDP presidential campaign organization also seeks to caution the chairman of the Independent National Electoral Commission, Professor Yakubu Mohammed, to immediately disentangle himself and his commission from fresh plot by the APC and the Buhari presidency to compromise the electoral guideline and pave the way for the alteration of the results of the 2019 general election in favor of President Buhari. We urge Professor Yakubu to note that Nigerians are already aware of the pressure being placed on him by the Buhari presidency and the APC, seeking to force the commission to drop the display of results at the polling units, as well as the electronic transmission of poll figures to INEC server from its guidelines. The Buhari presidency, in its desperation to remove these requirements, know fully well that the display of results at the polling units ensures that results posted at all levels remain those originally announced at the various polling units, while the electronic transmission to INEC server will guarantee that the results from the polling centers are not tampered with. The PDP has also demanded that INEC must allow international and local observers at the situation room so that as the figures are being tallied, it will guarantee transparency. The APC and Buhari presidency are mounting pressure on INEC to drop this basic requirement that will guarantee transparency in our elections, so as to pave way for their planned alteration of results and allocation of fictitious figures to President Buhari during the collation process. Like we have always done, particularly in the case of Osun State and the election that was held in Osun, we will bust every rigging plan and every rigging plot of the APC ahead of 2019. Professor Yakubu must not succumb to the pressure of the Buhari presidency, because doing so will definitely set him on a collision course with Nigerians. This demand has also become very imperative in the face of allegations and public apprehension that the INEC chairman is being offered humongous sums of money by agents of the APC and the cabal of the Buhari presidency to accede to their demands. Information at our disposal further reveals that the INEC chairman has been under pressure from this group, said to be coordinated by President Buhari's blood relation in INEC, who, we are surprised, Professor Yakubu still allows around himself. Professor Yakubu is now cancelled to distance himself and the commission from these very dangerous racketeers, as Nigerians will directly hold him responsible should these two important guidelines that guarantee transparency in the election suddenly disappear from the INEC manual. It has further come to our knowledge that the INEC chairman is contemplating the deployment of past National Youth Service Commission members for the 2019 election. The PPCO totally rejects this ignoble intention, which is a ploy to use APC card-carrying members as polls officers. It is very instructive to state that the ongoing ASU strike has not, by any measure, evacuated the members of ASU from the surface of the earth. Therefore, if INEC sought to use the members of ASU for the 2019 election, the ongoing strike will not be an excuse to begin to go down the streets of our nation and be deploying APC members as polls officers. We totally reject this plot to thwart electoral transparency in 2019, and we invite lovers of democracy and global democratic institutions to show more than a passing interest in our democratic process. On the whole, the PPCO invites Professor Yakubu to bear in mind that Nigerians demand a transparent, free, fair, and credible election. Thank you very much. Let me start by saying that report has no name to it. They didn't give us the name of the governor that said that. But having said this, let me make it abundantly clear to you and through you to Nigerians that no PDP governor, and I insist, no PDP governor is going to work for President Muhammadu Buhari. None will work with him. And the reasons are very clear. They are manifest. One, they don't share ideologies. Two, the Buhari government has demonstrated deviousness and viciousness against the PDP and all its members. So no man, no human being would deliberately walk to death. Having said that also, it's on record that in 2003, AD governors in the Southwest work for President Olusegun Obasanjo. And after working for him, the story of what happened is still being told today. And I believe that we all learn from history. There is no governor, whether in the north or in the south, that will go and work for President Buhari in hope of what? To get what? To secure what? As a matter of fact, the APC and President Muhammadu Buhari will shamelessly lose 2019 election because they have been rejected by majority of Nigerians. And that is the fact on the street. And there's no manipulation that they will attempt in INEC that Nigerians will not resist. So the question of a particular governor said that they will not work for a candidate is a fabrication. And as usual, that is the best area of the All Progressives Congress. They tell lies, they deceive people, they contrive, they beguile, and they deceive. So they are just thriving in their area. Another thing that they do well in, outside this, is the blame game. And they can even blame God if they have the opportunity for their own manifest failures.